the birds would not be the answer or the solution to our problem.
We are eliminating the birds at the source.
Let's pretend I'm a working mom and I go to work and I'm an accountant. All day there's numbers, 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 right? There's a lot of stress on my head.
It's been moved by the members of Heinz, seconded by the members of Edward, the club, one of the girls.
Yes!
Cheerleaders, Dina, and it's from Carol. Okay. Women stay at home as many families do not have children right after marriage. And many couples don't even have children at all.
Every wise woman builds her house.
We live in a democratic society.
First deal here. You're all like, wow, I can't be a doctor because I gotta stay at home. Has anybody ever heard of correspondence courses?
And in this democratic society, we have the right to free choice.
First 5 years of a child are the most important ones, and you need to establish those morals in creating your child.
And with the right to free choice, we have the right to choose whether we go to work or whether we stay home.
If we allow immigrants to come into Canada without a background check, and they were to get in a position of power, they could put Canadians at a high risk.
Many illegal immigrants are living within Canadian borders.
This call makes immigrants sound very cool.
And there are approximately 4,971,070 immigrants in Canada.
Having these new rules, they may change their minds about wanting to come into Canada.
We have the most strict and the best immigration policies in the world.
It's better than losing Canadian citizens because of terrorist attacks.
Policies are working right now is working for us.
I can just see it now. Here comes Grandma who's with this guy trying to take over Canada with all my arm.
I'm really disappointed in all the racist comments that are coming from me.
I believe that if I heard the Honorable Member of McGill correctly, that she wanted that grandma to be able to get into it so we're not being racist against it.
Do you want to be defended by undertrained soldiers marching out to battle?
Conscription isn't the answer. The wars today are technology and intelligence wars. So more soldiers would not benefit.
Look at the Israel. They ask conscription to be prepared. They always are prepared, ready.
Sure, Israel's always prepared for war, but how's their country?